as stewards of this place, we all agree on a base level thing that we want to protect the environment. We have about 50% of our property on Block Island in permanent conservation. I see offshore wind being something that's going to impact us on a huge scale. The smallest town in the smallest state was leading the way with this project, and it could have positive ramifications for generations to come. My name is Brian Wilson. I'm the manager of the Block Island Wind Farm for Ørsted. I'm a member of this community. So Block Island is a lot of people characterize it as paradise. About 7 miles long and 3 miles wide, 12 miles offshore of Rhode Island. Might as well be 1,000 miles offshore on certain days. You find people come here for, one, the natural beauty of the place. Block Island has a very strong environmental ethos. We had diesel generators to create our power on Block Island. Burned up to 1 million gallons of diesel fuel a year and ejected every other pollutant into the air over this pristine island. We trade those 5 diesel generators for 5 offshore wind turbines. Now we are 100% green electrons floating around Block Island. It's an amazing feat. Block Island is very, very attuned to the fact that we have something very special here and that we need to take care of it.
I'm Sue Tev Gibbons. I'm currently the high school science teacher. Wind is incredibly important to Block Island and a real constant in our lives. Our lives are still driven by wind and weather and ocean, and so you have to be a part of that to be here. When we switched over from our diesel generators to the turbines, there was a really, really cool moment. You hear the generators wind down and shut off. You hear nothing except a bird. As a science teacher out here, I do think I have some particular motivations. I am a strong voice about the fact that this is an important change for a community like this. Wind is kind of in our DNA, and so the use of wind to run our homes and our businesses on our island seems to make sense. It's really important to us that the students who grow up and learn on Block Island become aware of the environment that they live in, that they become good stewards of Block Island.
My name is Amira Bowman Wilson, and I'm a student at the Block Island School. I would describe myself as a climate activist. I've known a lot of people, especially in the school, that didn't really think about how the environment was being affected by our generators. And then when we switched over to green, they were like, oh, wow. I was really excited and pumped. I thought it was really cool. We were going to be the first to have this kind of thing, especially in the country, because we're such a small community. And I really just loved the idea of having green energy. When I look at the turbines, I definitely feel a sense of pride in seeing that as such a small community, we've done something so big and I got to be part of it. I definitely see us as a spearhead for green energy in the United States, especially offshore. I think we're going in a good direction. I hope that other states and other countries notice what we've done here on Block Island.
I'm Captain Hank Hewitt. I'm a charter boat fishing captain. The main reason I came to the island was to fish. Throughout the main part of the summer season, my life has lived more on the water than it is on land. Basically, what's happening with the wind turbine is that it has a potential to be an artificial reef for a lot of species that are in decline and potentially overfished right now. It creates habitat. You look at the studies on what presence it has, and so far it does not seem to have any negative impact on the species of fish that you find in the area.
I'm
hoping that the future generation of the environmental stewards will look at better, more efficient ways to harness and store the energy that's gained from what's in the water. I love them out there. That's a sign of progress, growth, getting away from the nature of what fossil fuels do to the environment. I'm all for it.
I'm Kim Gaffett. I'm a licensed bird bander. Bird study is still taught at the school here, so it's really important to the sort of the local community. Birds have been migrating to and from Block Island, you know, long before there were bird banders to catch them and band them. And it's been well known as a migratory stopover place. Well, when we started first, you know, considering having wind turbines off the shore, of course, one of the first concerns was for wildlife and especially birds. But I feel like it's been pretty well dispelled. It's been shown that location is important, and once you solve that, having the turbines there is not a big conflict with the bird population.
When we talk about stewardship, it's stewardship on many levels. It's not just conservation of land, it's also conservation of how people live here, what kind of people are involved in the community. I think people, when they come to Block Island for the first time, quite often sense that this is something special. It's a small project, but it's opened the floodgates on much larger projects that are going to prove to be beneficial to not only the state or our country, but beneficial on a global scale.